Hello kids, today we are going to revise the lesson number 10, soil erosion and conservation, lesson number 11, rocks and minerals. Today we are going to revise the lesson number 10 and 11. In the soil erosion and conservation lesson, we learned about soil erosion and its causes, overgrazing, deforestation, yes or no, okay, and soil conservation, how to conserve the soil, afforestation, terrace farming, building burns, shelter belt and cover crops. From this we conserve the soil, yes or no, we conserve the soil by afforestation, terrace farming, building burns, shelter belt and cover crops. In this lesson we learned soil erosion, soil conservation, okay. So the whole lesson we are going to revise in some points. Let us see here. One, the process of carrying away of topsoil by strong wind and water is called the soil erosion. The process of carrying away of topsoil by strong wind and water is called the soil erosion. Two, physical force like a wind, water and activities such as a deforestation and overgrazing causes soil erosion. In the lesson we learned grazing, deforestation, how are they causes to soil erosion, physical forces like a wind, water. Next is number 3, soil can be protected through afforestation, terrace farming, building burns, developing shelter belts and growing a crop, cover crops. Understood the case? Here lesson division over. Now we are going to revise the exercise. Fill in the blanks. Give one word answers. Answer the following question. We all this one solved. Now we are going to revise this one. Exercise. Fill in the blanks by selecting the correct options from those given in the bracket. A. Soil is the dash given. We wrote here topmost. Soil is the topmost layer of the earth's crust. Correct. B. The roots of plants and trees hold the soil tightly and thereby prevent the soil erosion. Yes. Who hold the soil tightly? Roots. The roots of the plants, trees hold the soil tightly. C. Afforestation helps in conservation of soil. Yes, correct. Afforestation of soil helps in conservation of soil. Afforestation, terrace farming, building burns, etc. all helps in conservation of soil. D. Grass is generally grown as a cover crop. Grass is generally grown as cover crop. E. Shelter belt means plant and trees along the edge of the field to prevent the soil erosion. Shelter belt means plant and trees along the edge of the field to prevent the soil erosion. Okay, here fill in the blanks over. Next, number 2, give one word for following. A. A fertile layer of soil. Fertile layer of soil is called the topsoil. B. The kind of farming done in hilly areas, terrace farming. C. Mixture obtained after mixing the cover crops in the soil, green manure. D. Low stone wall built along the river banks. E. Protection of soil against erosion is called the soil conservation. Understood, Nakias? Now we are going to revise the question answers. Answer the following questions. Question A. What is soil erosion? What is soil erosion? Answer. At time, physical force such as a wind, water carry away the topsoil to the different place. This happens especially in a place where there is no vegetation. There, this wearing away of topsoil is called the soil erosion. Question B. What are the causes and ill effect of deforestation? Answer. As the population grow, man has often cleared the forest to make a place available for farmlands, houses, residential areas, townships, roads and so on. As the population grow, man has often cleared forest to make a places available for farmlands, houses, residential areas, townships, roads and so on. This large scale clearing of forest is called the deforestation. The roots of plants hold and bind the topsoil together. Deforestation loosens the topsoil. This loses soil blown and washed away by wind and water. This leads to soil erosion. Okay. Now next question. Question C. How does afforestation help in the conservation of soil? Answer. Afforestation means planting more and more trees so as to provide vegetation cover to the exposed soil. Roots of plants and trees hold the soil tightly and thereby prevent soil erosion. Understood, no kids? How does the afforestation help in the conservation of soil? Next question. D. What is terrace farming? How does it prevent soil erosion? What is terrace farming? How does it prevent the soil erosion? Answer. In hilly areas, rainwater flows down with a much force carrying a lot of soil with it. Hence, farming on hills is done by cutting a step in the slope. This slows down the flow of rainwater and also reduces soil erosion. Terrace farming is seen in hilly regions. Understood, kids? What is terrace farming? How does it prevent the soil erosion? In hilly areas, rainwater flow down with a much force carrying a lot of soil with it. Hence, a farming on hill in a down by cutting a step in slope. This slow down the flow of water and also reduce the soil erosion. Terrace farming is seen in the hilly regions. Next question. Are cover crops important? Justify your answer. Yes, cover crops are important. If a farmer reaps just once a crop a year, then the field remains unprotected for longer time. This makes the soil vulnerable to erosions, a cover crop is a crop planted primarily to the manage soil erosion, soil fertility and the soil quality. Grass is generally grown as the cover crop so that the soil is held together until the next crop grown. Understood na kids? Why cover crop is important? Cover crop is very important because if a farmer wraps just one a crop year, then the field remain unprotected for longer time. This makes the soil vulnerable to the erosion. A cover crop is a crop planted primarily to manage soil erosion, soil fertility and soil quality. Grass is generally grown as a cover crops so that the soil is held together until the next crop grows. Understood the kids? Here question answers revision over. Now we are going to revise the question number 4. Give reasons for the following. A. Soil erosion is a very slow down in the forest area. Why? Answer. In the forest area, there are many trees and the small bushes that provide the green cover to the top. Most soil roots of plants, trees hold the soil tightly and thereby preventing soil erosion. Second one, B. Ramachandra has planted a rows of mango trees along the edge of his rice field. Why? Ramachandra has planted a row of mango trees along the edge of the rice to stop the erosion due to the wind and water. They are called the shelter belts and are also effective in preventing the soil erosion. Okay kids, here are soil erosion and conservation lesson revision, exercise revision over. Now we are going to revise this lesson, rocks and minerals. In lesson rocks and minerals, we learned about different types of rocks. Igneous rocks, that granite, pumice and basalt. Sedimentary rocks, conglomerate, sandstone, shale, limestone. Metamorphic rocks, minerals and ores. In this lesson, we learned all these. Okay? So, now we are going to revise the lesson. Let us revise. 1. The solid part of the earth's crust called rock. The solid parts of the earth's crust is called the rocks. There are three types of rocks: igneous rocks, sedimentary, metamorphic rocks. Igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks. 3. Granite, pumice, basalt are some igneous rocks. 4. Conglomerate, sandstone, shale, limestones are the sedimentary rocks, and quartzite, marble, slate, gneiss are some metamorphic rocks. Ore and rocks that contain one and more metal in reasonably large quantity along with other unwanted substances. 7. Rocks are made up of substances called the minerals. 8. Minerals are of two types, metallic minerals and non-metallic minerals. Okay kids, here lesson division over. Now we are going to revise the exercise. Fill in the blanks by selecting the correct option from those given in the bracket. We already filled it. Give the example, given the example, matched it. Answer the questions. Now we are revising the exercise. So let us see. A. Magma. What is the answer? What we have filled here? Magma is the molten and semi-molten rock mixture found under the surface of the earth. B. Rocks containing the useful metals in a large quantity are called the ores. C. The red hot flowing magma. Red hot flowing magma that reaches the surface of the earth through a volcanic vent is called the lava. What is our fill in the blanks answer? Is there lava? The red hot flowing magma that reaches the surface of the earth through a volcanic vent is called the lava. D. Pumice is a unique light porous rock formed when the molten lava cools very quickly. E. Slate is formed from shale. Slate is formed from shale. Okay, here fill in the blanks over. Now we are going to revise the two question number two. Give two examples for the following. A. Igneous rocks. Just we are revised that one. Yes or no, kids? Igneous rocks are granite, pumice, basalt. B. Sedimentary rocks, conglomerate, shale, sandstone, limestones. C. Metamorphic rocks are quartzite, marble, slate and gneiss. Okay, now next C kids, match the columns. A. Granite. What is the use of the granite? Granite is used to construct the rocks. Names and uses are there. Granite is used to construct monuments and tombs. Pumice is used by dentists to polish teeth. Conglomerate is used to manufacture decorative tiles. Chalk is used to write on blackboard. Sandstone, it is used to construct temples and homes. Understood, no kids? Okay, next turn the page. See, next question is there. 4. Answer the following question. Question A. State one difference between the magma and lava. Answer. The magma is very hot, molten, semi-molten rocks mixture present in the interior of the earth. The magma that flow out of a volcanic eruption is called the lava. Understood, na kids? What is the magma and what is the lava? Question B. State three uses of shale. Shale is largely used in making tiles, bricks, pottery. It is also mixed with the limestone when manufacturing cements. See, how are sedimentary rocks formed? Rocks are broken into particles due to the force of the nature, such as a wind, rain, hail and intense heat of the sun. These particles or sediment get carried away by the wind and rain to rivers, lakes and the seaway. They will slowly sink down to the bottom and settle down in the layer. The weight of the sediments on the top squeezes them in the lower layers. Sedimentary rocks are formed over millions of years. Next question D. How do sedimentary rocks changes into metamorphic rocks? Answer. Metamorphic rocks are formed when sedimentary rock and igneous rocks that have been buried deep inside the earth undergo changes due to the intense heat and pressure present there. Now last question. Name the some minerals used as a chairs. Answer. Metallic minerals are those that contain a metals and are. Sorry. Question E. What are metallic and non-metallic minerals? What are metallic and non-metallic minerals? Metallic minerals are those that contain metals and are used to make wire, coin, pots, pans, machines and the part of the vehicles. Minerals are that contain a diamond, graphite and non-metallic minerals. Okay, now next C. Question F. Name the some minerals used as gems. Answer. Minerals used as gems: emerald, sapphire, diamond, opal, and ruby. Minerals used as gems: emerald, sapphire, diamond, opal, and ruby. Last question number 5. Give reasons for the following. You see a small piece of rock floating in a bucket of water. What could it be? Why is it floating? Answer. It is a pumice stone. It is a unique light and porous rock formed when the molten lava cools very quickly. During this rapid cooling, gases get trapped inside it and then escape through the pores, thus making it look like a spongy with a small holes and the pockets inside it. This makes pumice so porous that it can be float on water. Understood my kids? Here lesson division, exercise division over. Today's your homework is you read the lesson, read the exercise and buy the question answers too. Thank you for watching the video.